G'day, Starlo here. Flathead of one sort or another are found right around Australia, and they're a big hit with anglers, not least because of the fact that they're delicious to eat, cooked in all sorts of ways. But some people struggle with cleaning and preparing them. I don't claim to be any sort of expert, but I thought I'd share my favourite flatty preparation techniques with you. And if you go to the inner circle of Fishertopia, you'll also find some delicious recipes. For the purpose of this demonstration, I've got a pair of duskies of a similar size. I've scaled the slightly larger one at the top and left the scales on the other one, which I'm going to skin. Let's start with the scaled fish. The first thing to do is turn it on its side and lift these fins, the pectoral and pelvic, then slide your knife in behind them. Slice forward and down until you hit the backbone, but don't cut through it. Turn your knife over and follow the backbone towards the tail. Keep the blade angled down to stay right on the backbone and cut all the way through to the tail to remove the first fillet. There you go, a lovely meaty fillet of delicious white flesh, but it's certainly not boneless at this point. This rib cage area has lots of bones. We'll deal with that problem in a minute. First, let's knock the other fillet off. Same process. Turn the fish on its side, lift the fins, slide your knife in behind them and cut forward and down. Then, keeping the knife angled slightly down, slice all the way back to the tail to completely remove the fillet. As you can see, there's not a lot of meat left on the backbone, although you could certainly cut it up and cook it if you wanted to. The same goes for the belly and wings. Lots of people, including me, enjoy these. And you can even boil the heads up to make great fish stock. There's no need to waste anything. Okay, let's get back to our skin-on fillets and deal with that pesky rib area. The big trick here is to use your finger to feel for the line of rib bones. What we're going to do is cut down on either side of the ribcage assembly, exactly as I'm doing here. Stay as close to the bones as possible and cut right through to the skin and the cutting board underneath. Do exactly the same on both sides of the ribs. You've now isolated the ribs from the rest of the fillet. We need to cut right through and separate this rib assembly from the rest of the fillet now. It can be a little bit fiddly the first couple of times you do it, but you'll get quicker at it as you clean more flatties. And trust me, it's well and truly worth the effort if you get it right. There you go, that's the rib assembly removed, and with it most of the bones. Again, cook this bit up if you don't mind picking around a few bones. What you've now got is a Y-shaped fillet. There may still be a few bones in this belly area, and you should be able to feel them with your finger. Here you go, there's one at the front. I'll just take the knife and trim it off. It's as easy as that. In a perfect world, there'll be no bones in what we now have left, especially in the meaty shoulder and tail of the fillet. However, if you're cooking for folks who really hate bones, or for kids or elderly people, you can remove all risk by cutting off the belly flap. It's way too good to waste though, so put it aside for yourself. It's a really tasty portion. What we have left shouldn't contain any bones at all, just pure, delicious flathead meat. Now we're going to repeat the whole process with the other fillet. Feel for the line of bones, carefully cut down either side of it all the way through to the skin, and trim away the rib cage completely. Take your time and get it right. Again, we removed most of the bones. They're here in this rib cage area that we cut out. But still, take a moment to feel for any strays left behind with your fingers, and if you find them, trim them out. We end up with another succulent skin-on fillet, ready for all sorts of recipes. But let's assume we're cooking for fussy kids or other family members and remove that problematic belly flap as well. It won't go to waste. What's left can be confidently served to anyone, and as you can see, it's a nice big portion. Right, time to tackle the fish I left the scales on. The filleting process is exactly the same as before. Turn it on its side, lift the fins, cut down and forward to the backbone, turn your knife, keeping it angled slightly down and follow the spine all the way through to the tail, removing the fillet. Clean off any internal organs that might come away with it, set it aside. Oh, and one important thing, take a moment at this point to remove any scales from the knife blade, being careful not to cut yourself. Now repeat the process to remove the second fillet. In behind the fins, down to the backbone, and back to the tail. Okay, we're going to skin these fillets, so the next steps are slightly different to the skin-on fillet. Firstly, I'm going to slice right along the midline of the fillet, from the tail to the ribcage, but only about halfway through to the skin. You'll see why in a second. When I get to the start of the ribs, I push down harder and go all the way through to the skin and the cutting board, travelling along the top or shoulder side of the bones. Then repeat this process on the belly side of the rib assembly, as I'm doing here. Again, cut all the way through to the board. Remember that slice I made halfway through the fillet, all the way from the tail? Well, you're about to see why I did it. It's to help the fillet lay flat so we can skin it properly. To skin any fillet, start at the tail wrist, working your knife between the meat and the skin like this. But then comes the critical bit. When there's enough of a tag to firmly hold, grab the skin and proceed to pull on that skin and drag the fillet back and forth across a virtually stationary knife blade that's angled slightly down. This is the big secret to easy skinning, and the end result should be a single piece of skin like this with very little meat left on it. Now, back to our skinned fillet, and we need to finish removing the rib cage. There we go, most of the bones are gone, they're in this bit. What we have left is a largely boneless fillet, just like the first fish, but with its skin removed. Again, feel carefully for any stray bones and trim them away if necessary. Nice, I can almost taste that coated in panko breadcrumbs and lightly shallow fried. Yum! But, just like before, if you're serving very picky eaters or people at risk from swallowing bones, you can always remove that belly flap area and set it aside for yourself. What's left should be bone-free. Alright, let's very quickly repeat the process on the other fillet. Slice lightly along the midline, cut down either side of the rib cage, start at the tail and separate the meat from the skin, firmly grasp the skin and saw the fillet back and forth as you drag it through the angled blade to remove the skin in one piece. Then remove that pesky rib cage. Tidy up the skinless fillet and we're almost done. Except I just felt a bone I missed. Here it is. Can you see it? Someone's going to complain about that at dinner time. I could easily pull it out with a pair of tweezers if I had some handy, but I'm just going to carefully cut it away instead. No more bones. A tidy, skinless, bone-free fillet. Job's done, and it's time to hit the kitchen. Bon appetit!